Greetings, my brothers and sisters, in the name of God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Periodically, I like to bring you a strategic update that Brian, our Director of Communications, and I tall the Dean's List. Just a quick couple of bullet points of high-level looking at what is going on in the life of the EPC to keep all of us on the same page, tracking together and moving forward. That's important because we've just come out of our National Leadership Team meeting annual retreat, which we typically do the third week of August. It's a great time for not only onboarding new leaders, but beginning to do some deep dive into how do we carry out the vision and mission of the EPC. At this last retreat, we basically spent a good bit of time looking back at who we are, who God has made us to be as a denomination, our culture, our ethos, our DNA, our history, so that faithfully in trajectory of that, we could move forward into the things that God has calling us to. And those things ought to be consistent with one another. We're not doing anything new. As Ecclesiastes says, there's nothing new under the sun. And so we look back and see who God has made us to be. That gives us our sense of purpose and direction as we move forward for what God is calling us therefore to do. And what we're called to do is our mission. And the EPC's mission statement, of course, is we exist to carry out the Great Commission as Presbyterian Reformed Evangelical and Missional Churches. And the National Leadership Team settles down on that mission statement every year at this time to make sure that we as an organization are in missional alignment. In other words, is what we're doing in alignment with what our mission is, because a mission statement is an action statement. Now you'll notice our mission statement, we exist to carry out the Great Commission as Presbyterian, Reformed, Evangelical, and Missional Churches. That second part says who we are, Presbyterian, Reformed, Evangelical, Missional. The first part, we exist to carry out the Great Commission, is what we do. And what we do flows out of who we are. And so by doing that kind of alignment, we're able to say, yes, let us move forward with a singular kind of focus in something like evangelism. And so if you've heard any of my stump speeches at the Presbytery or at the General Assembly this last year, you know that my preaching point is we're putting the E back in EPC. And that E stands for evangelism and training people using the three circles tool that we've developed, or whether it might be how to create and cultivate an evangelistic culture in our presbyteries and congregations that supports people doing evangelism. But evangelism is alignment with our mission, which is to carry out the Great Commission. But so are our other strategic priorities. In fact, as you look at all four of our strategic priorities, whether it's a global movement or transformation or multiplication or effective biblical leadership, all four of those things are ways in which we get after our mission statement, which is carrying out the Great Commission. And the more we think about carrying out the Great Commission through those four strategic priorities, we realize those four strategic priorities are actually gospel priorities. The way in which the good news is carried out, which is the Great Commission, is through world outreach, that's global, church planning, that's multiplication, church health, that's transformation, and of course, effective biblical leadership, which is really discipleship. So we really look at alignment and how are we moving forward in accomplishing those things. And to that end, I'm grateful to be able to share with you that after having added Bob Stauffer as our National Director of Church Health, we've now added, thankfully, after years of faithful service, Tom Ricks as our National Director of Church Planning. And so with Tom Ricks over church planning, Bob Stauffer over church health, Gabriel DeGuia over global outreach, and Michael Davis over effective biblical leadership, we've got great leaders in place us to help us carry out these gospel priorities in alignment with our mission, which is to carry out the Great Commission. And that's the kind of stuff that the National Leadership Team wrestles with, and I thought you might like to know. So until the next time when the Dean's List comes to you with another strategic update, grace and peace to you, my friends, in our Lord Jesus Christ.